everyone, my name is Bruno, and I'm gonna partially review to you a new stablecoin protocol on which we have been working together with Alexander Chapurnoy, Ki, and Sanjit, and with the support of the JED Alliance. The name of this new stablecoin protocol is Gluon W plus minus. So what are the motivations and inspirations for this new protocol? Well, one of them, of course, is JED and SigmaUSD, its first deployment on Ergo. To know more about this protocol, watch the presentation that I did for Ergo Summit in 2021. Now, this protocol has been performing quite well on Ergo. It has survived all the market crashes since early 2021, whereas many other stablecoins out there have failed. But even though it is good, that doesn't mean that it cannot be made better, right? It doesn't mean that we cannot come up with a better protocol. And yeah, nothing is ever perfect, you know, especially when it comes to stablecoins. We are aware, for example, of its sensibility to the Oracle and reserve drainage by whales, of the inconvenience for reserve coin holders, you know, to be unable to sell back reserve coins when the reserve ratio is below the threshold. We're also concerned about the zero equity problem, right? And there are many other issues that we have covered in this talk for the Ergo Summit 2022. And even in the white paper of JED itself, we are quite clear about those issues, and we also propose some ideas for a future extended JED protocol, right, of how those issues could be addressed. At the same time, you know, there are all these different ideas and it's unclear how to proceed. It's unclear which direction would be better to pursue. At least it was unclear to me until very recently, but maybe about 2 months ago, I had a kind of eureka moment where I came up with this new stablecoin protocol while thinking about liquidity pools and thinking about what exactly is the relationship between JED and liquidity pools, right? So why is it interesting to think about liquidity pools, right? Because liquidity pools have an inherent protection against large volumes through the constant product formula. It becomes increasingly more expensive to swap assets. So my idea was to try to exploit that by creating a new stablecoin protocol that would be not a liquidity pool, but the dual of a liquidity pool. And this will become clearer later, right? But I want to stress this point now. So we're not thinking here, we're not talking here about a liquidity pool for the pair base coin, stable coin, you know, for the pair ERG and SigmaUSD. This is something that we already covered in a talk in 2021, you know, and it's also an idea that is pursued by other stablecoin protocols, including, for example, DEXI USD and DEXI Gold, right, that has been researched and developed on Ergo as well. With Gluon W plus minus, the idea is to think about like a dual pool for the pair stablecoin reserve coin for SIG RSV and SIGUSD, you know, something like that. So I started exploring this idea and eventually I realized that the actions in this protocol resemble nuclear physics reactions. And that's how I came up with the name Gluon W plus minus, right? Because we can think of stable coins as like neutrons and reserve coins as something similar to protons. And then gluon is the particle that mediates the strong force and keeps all matter stable in the universe. And W plus and W minus are particles that mediate the weak force and participate in the beta decay of protons to neutrons and neutrons to protons. Okay, so what are the actions of this new protocol, or what are the reactions, right? So the first action, the first reaction is fission. So instead of thinking of the base coin of ERG as something indivisible, we think of it as if it were an atomic nucleus, yeah, composed of neutrons and protons, of stable coins and reserve coins. And then with the fission operation, you can split this ERG into stable coins and reserve coins. Then the second action, the second reaction is fusion, where it's basically the opposite of fission, right? You can join the neutrons and protons together and get back your ERG. The third action is beta decay plus, which is similar to a swap in a liquidity pool. And so with beta decay plus, you can take a proton and you can transform it to some number of neutrons. And then you also have beta decay minus, where you can take some neutrons and transform them into protons. Okay, by now you're probably wondering, how many protons and neutrons will I get from performing a fission on my ERGs, right? Or how many protons and neutrons do I need to fuse them together and get back one ERG? How many neutrons will a proton decay? Or conversely, to how many protons will a neutron decay? And these questions are answered by the reaction equations, by the protocol's equations. So let's start by the price equations. Now, keep in mind that in this protocol, because you're not really just buying neutrons and buying protons, these price equations, they are more like an auxiliary concept. But it's a useful auxiliary concept. So as you can see in those equations, we have that Q function. What is this Q function? So imagine that we have the reserve here. Q will tell us the portion of the reserve that is backing the neutrons. And 1 minus Q will be the portion of the reserve backing the protons. So that's why to get the price of a neutron, we just multiply Q by the reserve to get the portion of the reserve that is backing the neutrons. And we divide by the supply of neutrons, which is this S with the white circle subscript. And similarly for the proton price. Now with these equations and with these concepts, we can come up with this table here. Where, for example, I'm using the yin-yang symbol there to represent ergs or base coins, right? And I'm using black dots to represent protons and white circles to represent neutrons. So, for example, in fission, if you give m ergs as input, then you get those amounts of protons and neutrons in the output column. And similarly, you can see the equations for fusion, beta decay plus and beta decay minus. And actually, if we unfold the definition of price in those equations, we can even simplify them a bit and we get something like this. Okay, now the secret sauce of this protocol are these two formulas, right? The Q ratio and the beta decay phi. Now it's beyond the scope of this talk to go into details of these formulas. That's why I said in the beginning that I would only partially review the protocol. But we can say that, so this Q function is the function that takes the oracle price into account. And one property that it has is that it's always lower than one, so that we don't have the zero equity problem that we had on minimal JED. Then for the beta decay phi, So this is the function that makes decays increasingly more expensive for large transactions and depending on market conditions. What is interesting to note is that reactions are always allowed. There are no behavioral discontinuities, you know, there are no thresholds under which or above which you are not allowed to perform certain actions. Okay, but then what if the user just wants to buy stable coins, just wants to buy reserve coins or sell them, you know, without doing... Because, for example, when you do a fission, it's like you're buying stable coins and reserve coins simultaneously. And when you do a fusion, you're buying... you're selling stable coins and reserve coins simultaneously. But maybe you don't want both of those coins, you know. Maybe you don't want to buy both coins simultaneously. Maybe you don't want to sell both coins simultaneously. So... then what we can do, we can still have those four operations, you know, buy and sell stable coins and reserve coins, not as primitive operations of the protocol, but as derived operations by composing the primitive reactions of the protocol. So for example, to buy only stable coins, we can do a fission. And then we can do a beta, so we do a fission and we get stable coins and reserve coins, but we don't want those reserve coins, right? So then we do a beta decay plus to transform those reserve coins into stable coins. And of course, we don't need to make the user do that explicitly, right? The front end, the user interfaces can do that for the user. Similarly, for buying reserve coins, we can do a fission and then beta decay minus. For selling stable coins, we can do beta decay minus and then fusion. And for selling reserve coins, we can do beta decay plus and then fusion. Okay, now let's dive a little bit deeper in this idea of duality to liquidity pools, right? In a liquidity pool, we have a pool and we have two assets, let's call them A and B. And then one of the operations we can do is to provide liquidity. So we deposit those two assets in the pool and we get an LP token. In Gloom W plus minus, we have a reserve and we have ERGs, right, the base coin. And we can do fission. So we deposit ERGs in the reserve and we get neutrons and protons. Now in the liquidity pool, we can withdraw. So we give back our liquidity provided token and we burn that token and we get back our two assets, A and B. In Gluon W plus minus, we do a fusion, right? We fuse neutrons and protons together and we get back our ERGs. And in liquidity pools, we can do a swap between A and B. And in Gluon, we can do beta decay. So it's interesting to notice that in the liquidity pool, the two assets, they stay in the pool, right? Whereas in Gloom, it's one asset that stays in the pool, right, in the reserve, and the two assets that are generated live outside the reserve, outside the pool. So there's a duality in this sense, and also in the sense that you can see here that one is just the mirror image of the other. So we were working really hard to have a beta on a testnet for this Ergo Summit, but unfortunately we didn't manage to finish on time, but implementation on Ergo is in progress of this protocol, and we hope that it will become Sigma Gold. Key is implementing the contract on the back end, and Sanjit is implementing the front end. And we will use the new Gold Oracle, the same Oracle that DexiGold will use. And if Sigma Gold works well, we could perhaps update Sigma USD to use Gluon W plus minus instead of minimal JED. Or we could keep Sigma USD as is and deploy a new USD stablecoin based on Gluon W plus minus. So thank you, and you're welcome to join our Discord server. Please follow us on Twitter and star and fork our GitHub repos. Thank you.